What's up, Rebels? Today, we're gonna get like granular. We're gonna get like nitty gritty into like what might be one of the most important tactics, one of the most important skills you can learn when it comes to freelance writing. And you guess what it is? Nope, bet you can't. Well, unless you read the title, in which case you probably can. We're gonna be talking about letters of introduction and why that's different from sending a pitch, why it's one of the most important skills you can cultivate, and how to learn how to craft a killer letter of introduction that's gonna get you all kinds of clients. Because that's one thing I've continued to hear over and over again. The biggest struggle that most of you have when it comes to freelance writing is getting your first clients, or continuing to get clients, getting high quality clients. Well, this is one tactic that's gonna help you start landing a lot more of them on a regular basis, and it's gonna be awesome. But we're getting kind of detailed with this one. This is like, you know, starting to get into more intermediate advanced freelance writing pitching. So let's roll the intro, stop my rambling, and get on with it. First off, what is a letter of introduction? Well, it's pretty simple. It's a letter, or in most cases, an email, where you send it to a potential client, introducing yourself, your background, some of your writing abilities, your services, and just saying hi. Now, one of the best things about a letter of introduction is it can be a great way to introduce yourself without pitching, without being spammy, by just connecting with an actual human being to say, hey, I'm an actual human being. You're an actual human being. Let's maybe work together, but maybe not. I just want to let you know I'm out here, I'm available. If you work with freelancers, if you're looking for more freelancers, if you're looking for writers, I'm here. Let's chat. No stress, no pressure. That's what a letter of introduction does, as opposed to being like, hire me right now. I'm the best. Hire me. Don't hire those other 10,000 people to pitch to you. Hire me. That's a pitch. Well, that's a crappy pitch, but that's kind of what a lot of people do. All right, so now that we've kind of talked about what a letter of introduction is, let's talk about how a letter of introduction is different from sending a pitch. So generally, when you're sending a pitch, you are applying to a specific job. You're on a job board, someone has posted something, they said, we're looking for a writer that can do this. So you're gonna pitch why you think you're that person. You're trying to get an immediate response. You're trying to land a job right now. Let's think about dating. Use dating as an example. A letter of introduction is just saying like, hey, I'm around. Let's go grab coffee sometime. Get to know each other. Maybe something good will happen, maybe it won't. Whereas a pitch is like, yo, I'm looking to make babies and get into a long-term relationship right now. Are you in? Are you out? Let's go. In? Out? Don't know. So it's that casual, let's get to know each other versus I want to work with you right now. I'm trying to get you to hire me immediately. And it's not saying one is better than the other. It just depends on what the job is, who the potential client is, what they're looking for. If it's a cold pitch, if you're sending them something out of the blue, or if you're responding to an actual job title or actual request for pitches. So it kind of depends on the situation. But at its most simple form, a letter of introduction is a less salesy way to introduce yourself and get to know people that you might work with in the future. So here's an actual letter of introduction that our community manager Liz has used to get an actual client. She sent this LOI to 10 people. She got 3 responses, which led to 2 phone calls, which led to 1 new client. So 10% batting rate, that's pretty good when it comes to sending out LOIs. So here's what it said. Hi, I recently moved to Portland and wanted to connect with some local agencies. I've written for brands primarily in the finance and insurance industries, including Client 1, Client 2, and Client 3. I saw on your site that you do work with freelancers, so here I am. I'm happy to work on a per project basis, and my rates are blank an hour. You can find my portfolio here. Take care, Liz. It's as simple as that. It's a concise email that says, here's what I do, here's what I charge, here's where you can learn more about me. If you're interested, let me know. Okay, now you know what an LOI is. You know what the difference between a pitch is. You've seen an example of a pretty good letter of introduction. And as much as possible, you want to personalize these to the people you're sending it to. I know that you tweaked that a little bit to say, hey, I see that you're in the Pearl District. I live close by, or things like that. So add different specifics that are relevant to your experience with the person that you're emailing to. All right, so a few more tips just to make sure that the letters of introduction you send out are going to be as valuable as possible and actually get you potential new freelance writing clients and leads. The first thing, short and sweet. Don't want to go too long. You notice with Liz's example, it's just 5 or 6 sentences. The longer on you go, the bigger the paragraphs, the less time people have to read it. And they'll probably just say, oh, I'll read that later. and then never read it. So short and sweet, give them all the pertinent information, be as personable as possible, and then leave the door open to them for them to continue the conversation if they're interested. Next, you wanna make it as relevant as possible to your target audience. So in Liz's case, that was local. She was living in Portland, or she is living in Portland, and she was reaching out to local agencies. So let them know that you're local. Often people are getting pitches from all over the world. So if you are pitching people in your local area, let them know. Let them know that you're free for a phone call or a cup of coffee. You can actually get together, meet face to face, because there's a lot to be said for that. If someone meets you face to face, the chances of you getting the job, much higher. Or if you're not pitching people locally, make sure you're personalizing it to their needs in a different way. Maybe you've niched down your writing services. Maybe you're just targeting one industry. So letting them know, hey, I only write for clients like you. I am only writing in this industry. That's gonna make you much more appealing to the generalist who's blasting out to tons of different companies in tons of different industries. As much as possible, showcase your samples. If you only have a handful of them, maybe you're brand new and you literally just wrote your samples today. Link to those individually, and especially link to the ones that are going to be most pertinent and most relevant to your client that you're sending the letter of introduction to. It might in some cases be necessary for you to create a sample that's going to be relevant to that niche or to that industry. And if you do have a portfolio website, which I really recommend getting as quickly as possible, it's gonna allow you to get your personality across and really show that you are a professional, that you do this for a business. Make sure you highlight any specific aspects of the site that are gonna be particularly relevant to this client. So if you've got a whole page about, you know, samples in whatever industry they're in, make sure that you point them to that page. Next, be yourself. Unless you suck as a person, then maybe try and be something else. But my guess is, because you're watching our video here, you don't suck. You're a great person. So be yourself. It's your unique background. It's your personality. It's your unique set of skills that are gonna make you more desirable or more interesting compared to somebody else. And most people, they get too businessy. They send like the same template emails, the same buzzwords. Be a real person. We talk about this all the time in our videos. Be a real person. Know that you're emailing and introducing yourself to a real person. And if you do that, then you've got a big leg up on everybody that's not doing that, which fortunately for you, is just about everybody. So next up, one of the most important things you can do is try and get a little bit of engagement. Try and get them to actually respond. It could be as simple as just asking them a question like, hey, I don't wanna waste any of your time, just wanna know, do you work with freelancers? If so, I'll send you some more information. Or maybe if it seems appropriate, you can say, hey, are you free for a cup of coffee? Or hey, are you free to hop on a call and talk about whether or not this is a good fit? Try and get them to say yes or no. If it's just strictly an informational email, there's not going to be as much incentive for them to respond. But if they know that you're waiting on a response for them, then it's gonna make them more likely to at least give you a yes or a no, so that's gonna allow you to move on. So try and get engagement one way or another with them. And finally, one of the most overlooked aspects I've seen both in letters of introductions, cold pitches, whatever it is your subject line. That's gonna be the first thing they see. And if you have a crappy subject line that's not gonna make them want to open the email, then the rest of it doesn't even matter. I mean, your whole goal is like, first, get them to open the email and read it. So I recommend testing out a few different strategies as far as this goes. We actually have a video all about blog post headlines, and this is a little bit different than email subject lines, but you can take some of the same cues because it's all about copywriting, it's all about getting someone to click on something. So go watch that video for some ideas on some subject lines that might work. But it could be as simple as, are you looking for freelance copywriters? That might be a way to go. Or maybe you could get a little more creative and say, 9 things I can do for your content writing business, or something like that. That's intriguing. That's gonna make someone wanna open it up. You just wanna make sure it doesn't come across as too spammy, too markety. A lot of times I'll get pitches for links or guest posts from copywriters that really try and get like clever and cute with their copy. And really it just makes them look like they're trying too hard and make me say, no, you know what? You're trying to sell me too hard in this email. You're not being yourself. So I'm just gonna hit delete and ignore that. So don't do that. And last, but I might've said the last one was the last one, but this one's actually the last one. And that's to track every LOI you send and to follow up. So make sure you know, hey, I've sent 20 LOIs over the course of the last week. Mark off which ones you've responded to. And if you haven't gotten a response in 4 or 5 days or a week or whatever, send a polite follow-up. Do not make it pushy. Do not waste their time. And remember my golden rule, my little trick that always gets you more yeses and more clients by saying, it's totally cool if. It's totally cool if you don't have time. It's totally cool if you're not looking for clients. Give them an easy out. That one tip alone, even though by making it easier for them to say no, you're actually making it more likely for them to say yes. So that's it. Letters of introduction. Probably haven't put a whole lot of thought into that aspect of freelance writing, but be honest, it's one of the best things you can do because it's playing the long game. It's building relationships. It's trying to make yourself valuable as opposed to like just going for the win, just going for the sale. There's a time and place for doing that with your pitches, but a letter of introduction is generally going to be more favorably received by agencies and businesses than saying, hey, hire me right now out of the blue. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit subscribe. We got new videos every Monday and Thursday. And if you are looking to build a freelance writing business, go check out locationrebel.com/FWG, which stands for Freelance Writing Guide. You can get our free freelance writing starter kit that's gonna help you start getting your first freelance clients. So check that out, hit subscribe, give this video a thumbs up. And with that, good luck with your business. Go check out Location Rebel. We got a bunch of great stuff. And when you watch this, I'm actually probably going to be in Wichita, Kansas. Actually, an hour outside Wichita, Kansas. Not very rebel-y, but it's kind of an interesting location, so you'll probably see some videos from there. But more on that at a later date. Now I'm just rambling. See you soon.